I want to look at these four derivatives of dichlorocyclobutane, and what I want to focus on for these four compounds that are shown here is the stereochemistry. Because if we look carefully at these molecules, what we'll find is that only one of the four actually can exist as a pair of enantiomers. In other words, of the four structures I've drawn, only one of these four structures has an enantiomer. And I wanted us to see how we can explain that and understand that. We're going to start with the 1,3 substituted dichlorocyclobutanes. We've got the trans substituted molecule and the cis substituted molecule. And what we're going to do is we're going to look at three-dimensional models of these. We're going to start with the trans substituted molecule. And this is the three-dimensional model right here. I can spin it and change its perspective and all of that kind of stuff. I could even zoom in and out if I wanted to, but I don't want to do that for this particular example. And one of the things we want to notice is that, or want to remember, I should say, is that in any chiral molecule, we do not have a mirror plane, a plane of symmetry going through the molecule. And what I want you to see is that in the trans 1,3 dichlorocyclobutane, we do have a plane of symmetry going right through the molecule just like this. And I can actually draw in that plane of symmetry if I want to, just like this. And you can see I've put in my plane of symmetry. It goes right through the two carbons that contain the chlorine, so through this carbon and through this carbon. It also splits the hydrogen and the chlorine in half on both of these atoms. But what you'll see is, if I line it up just like this, the left side of the molecule and the right side of the molecule are exact images of one another, the reflections of one another. So we have a mirror plane going right through the molecule and splitting those atoms right down the middle. Since this molecule right here has a mirror plane, it is not a chiral molecule. It does not exist as a pair of enantiomers. And since this one is not the one that has the enantiomer, I'm going to just cross it out so that we remember that we're not looking at that one anymore. Let's look at the cis version of the 1,3 dichlorocyclobutane. And again, we're going to look at the 3D model of it. And here it is. You can see that the chlorines are on the 1 and the 3 carbon. And you can see that they're both pointing in the same direction. So there's cis. And what I want you to notice is that, again, there is a mirror plane in this molecule going right down through these atoms. And I can draw, as I did before, I can draw in the mirror plane, or I should say mirror plane of symmetry, because it is a plane of symmetry going right through the molecule. And again, we can see that half of the molecule looks like this, the other half looks like that, and the two halves of the molecule are a reflection of one another, because this molecule has a plane of symmetry. And the plane of symmetry, again, goes right through the carbon 1 and carbon 3, through the chlorine, and the hydrogen, and the hydrogen. So we've eliminated this molecule as being the one that has an enantiomer. So I'll cross that one out as well. So that just leaves us with the two 1,2 dichlorocyclobutanes. So let's look at both of those. And again, we're going to want to look at the three-dimensional models of these compounds. Let's start with the cis version of the molecule, cis isomer. And the cis molecule model in three dimensions looks like this. And again, I can spin it around and reorient it however I want. Let me put it back close to the original form. And if we look at that mirror plane, it looks something like this, going right between the bonds for carbon 1 and carbon 2 and carbon 3 and carbon 4. And I can line it up just like this, and you can see that the left half of the molecule is a perfect image reflection of the right half of the molecule, because this is a plane of symmetry. So this first one in our list of 1,2 dichlorocyclobutanes is not the one that has an enantiomer. And by process of elimination, and based on what I've told you, we obviously know that this is going to be the one that is a chiral molecule. But I want to look at this anyways, because I want us to see what happens when we try to put the same plane of symmetry that we had in the previous example in this molecule. And the model is right here. We can see that the chlorines are on the 1 and the 2 carbon. We can see that they're trans to one another. And if we look for the same type of plane of symmetry we saw in the previous example, right down this bond, we can see that it's not there. And let me put in the actual plane of symmetry again. And when we do that, this is the same plane we had in the previous example when the chlorine was on the top. We can see now that the chlorine is on the bottom, there is not a plane of symmetry in this molecule. The left side of the molecule is not a mirror image of the right side, particularly if we focus on these two carbons right here. Because of that, we can say that this molecule does not have a plane of symmetry, and therefore it is a chiral molecule, and I could draw an enantiomer of it.